Hello everyone and welcome back to another video. Today I'm finally making another college admissions advice video because it's college admission season again and I've been getting a lot of DMs about it. One thing that I've been getting asked a lot about is how to stand out in your essays, because in one of my older videos I mentioned that I got into a lot of colleges that I didn't think that I was going to get into. So I just want to make a really honest video about that and try to help you all out as best as I can. Before I get into the video, I just want to say that everything that I'm going to be talking about is based on my own experience and based on my own opinion. I also don't think that there's any formula for getting into colleges, and I also didn't do any of the things that I'm going to mention in this video with college admissions in mind. It just really ended up helping me get into a lot of these schools. So now that that's out of the way, let's get into the video. When I was applying to colleges 3 years ago, I applied to a few reach schools, a few safety schools, and then some schools that were kind of in the middle of those two. I really didn't expect to get into that many of my reach schools, especially American University in DC. I really didn't think that I was going to get into that school. My test scores and grades were definitely below the average of people that got in there. So I was very surprised when my dad texted me at school and said that a big envelope from American had arrived. But I honestly think that the reason that I got into that school and a bunch of other schools and that I got scholarships at so many schools was because I ran for office when I was 18 and wrote my Common App essay about it. Obviously, this isn't going to work for those of you that aren't 18 yet. In most states, you have to be 18 to run for office, so that isn't going to work for a lot of you. I was really lucky to turn 18 a few days before I started my senior year of high school. For those of you that are 18 or live in states where you can run for office when you're 17, I would highly suggest running for public office. I didn't run for office because of college admissions at all. That thought didn't even cross my mind until a journalist that was interviewing me mentioned it, and then I realized that running for office might help me get into colleges, so I wrote my Common App essay about it, but I really didn't think about it at all until that journalist mentioned it. I don't think that you should run for office purely for college admissions reasons, but if I'm being honest, I really do think that that is the main thing that helped me get into my reach schools. Since most of you are probably still 17 and can't do that, there are some other things that you can do that'll help you stand out. Getting involved in politics or anything that young people aren't usually involved with is really going to help you stand out for college admissions. It shows that you care about the future of your state, country, or community. I'm still involved in politics and local government because it's something that I genuinely care about, and I think that you should all care about it as well. I'm 21 years old now, I'm in my third year of college. I have my official 21 plus ID card, but I still look like I'm in high school. So when I go to town halls or board meetings, people usually assume that I'm still in high school, and they're always really shocked and impressed that I'm there, even after I tell them my real age. So find out when city council meetings are, board of supervisors meetings are, transit board meetings are, town halls for candidates, or any other political meetings that are open to the public are, and show up and talk to people and stand up for what you believe in, and then write an essay about it or mention it in your application in some sort of way, and that will probably really help you get into the colleges that you want to go to. I know that a lot of these things are pretty scary and intimidating, especially when you're the youngest person in the room by a few decades. I'm not gonna lie, I was still pretty scared when I spoke at the VTA board meeting a few weeks ago in front of the mayor of San Jose and the rest of the board, but I'm really glad that I did it because things like that are really great opportunities to practice your public speaking skills and learn how to stand up for yourself and others. So that's my main suggestion for getting into your reach schools that people your age don't usually do. Will also probably work, but this is just what I personally have experience with. Even if you're not into politics or activism right now, going to these meetings will probably spark your interest. So that's pretty much everything that I wanted to say in this video. I know that this was probably a little bit more honest than most of my college admissions videos, because I usually just tell you all to follow your passions, but sometimes it's important to try new things so you can learn what you're passionate about, regardless of how old you are or whether you're applying to colleges or not. Try new things, expand your horizons. Even if something's scary, even if you fail, you're still gonna learn something about it and you're still gonna grow as a person. So that's my advice for getting into your reach schools. If you have any other questions, feel free to comment down below. And if you have any other college admissions topics that you want me to talk about, feel free to comment those down below as well. I really want to get back into making these videos because I know that a lot of you really like them. Thank you all so much for watching this video. Stay awesome, and I'll see all of you very soon with a new video. Goodbye.